waiting for the bus in his army green. Sat down in a booth in a cafe there. Gave his order to a girl with a bow in her hair. He's a little shy, so she give him a smile.
Back, there's an onrushing, there's somebody there to help her, and it's just looking to see if the ball, it gets the ball into Cora. Cora's going to take a shot from 35 yards out. Cora takes the shot. It looks good to me, and it looks good to the umpire, and that's over the bar. So just when you needed an answer, it was Cora that stepped up there with the score here. He's 4 points. Regis Sullivan plays the ball, but there's a player inside here. There's going to be a shot, and it's a great save. It's a great save by Yvonne Byrne. Yvonne Byrne, the old keeper, got down quickly. She got down to save from Niamh Cotter, number 17, Niamh Cotter, and that was a great save. And we had saves on the other end, but we have somebody who's worthy to the task here, Yvonne Byrne. Great save, Michelle.
Absolutely fantastic. And in fairness, Yvonne is absolutely brilliant at one-to-one saving shots. She really, really earned her.
Is a catch of Cora starting the hostage enough quick enough a hoch the hostage of Van Burn. Russian Tahinim Liam again Merchin of Shahunish, the Nihon Glasno, Neil Kelly, Goffin Tree her mud, good enough for sure. But his Jason Sogus Cooley and I'm sure again Neil Kelly, talk quite a down of a turban.
I was a reach Frago eat up we and our name was 100 points and Shen Sir Cool and Shen of Igni Potter and Frago top lawyer and Shen, Agashi, Neil Kelly and Shen on score and Shen Fort.
Gets shut up. It's a goal from Cora Sargent. Fantastic goal. She had three or four players hanging off her. It looked like the chance had passed there. It looked like they got people back. They got three stack back. But no, into the back of the net. And she put too much power on the goalie. Got a hand to put too much power on it.
Yeah, Niamh went through there. And in fairness, she tried to get her own shot off, but she got caught. And she ended up falling over. And fair play to her. She got the ball off to Cora. Cora jinked a few times, got the shot off. A great save from the keeper, but unfortunately, there's so much power behind it. It went in and over.
Gone in the second half here. 6 minutes gone, and it's 10 points to Cork. It's 1-9 to Mayo. So Cork starting really well here, but a poor kick out here. There could be a goal chance here. A poor kick out. Is there a goal for Cork? Takes a shot, and that's over the bar when the goal was wide open there. Again, we were talking about the Mayo keeper, but there was a poor kick out there from Yvonne Byrne, and it's again these short kick outs to put them under pressure.
She was awful lucky there. Number 13, actually, Anya Sullivan definitely went for the goal, whether she missed it or what, and it ended up going over the bar. Yvonne seems to be picked up an injury there now.
Far side, on the side, and we know how dangerous she could be. Just to check inside to Hughes. Hughes has the ball, plays it off there to Fiona Doherty. Fiona Doherty with the head down. She's going, she's making the yards here. She's coming through the middle, about 21, 25 yards out. There's a ball in, there's a ball chance here for Aileen Gilroy. What a goal! What a goal from Aileen! What a pass! That's a great bit of work there, and that came all the way from Grace Kelly right down here, working it up here, and that's a fantastic score and a fantastic team score.
Fantastic team score. Fair play to Aileen. I don't know how she got the ball. The pass to her wasn't perfect, but she got that ball, and you could know she was going to make up for what happened in putting the wide earlier, but it was by no means an easy shot.
She goes down the ball, but she's tackled by Marta Carter. Marta forces her to go out again. But this is good from, and the referee is going to play in. There could be a free here. No, he's waiting play on. There's a chance here. Finn, the ball into Finn. She's outside the goal. Is she going to take it on? She's right into the
paper. That is not a penalty.
Referee.
No way.
No. She seemed to carry the ball into the tackle.
She carried the ball into the tackle and just lies down. I mean,
that is
no way a penalty.
She seemed, if Anthony, I thought she was barging with the ball.
She was barging, in fairness. That was, I don't know. It's just...
Yes, Niall McCormick, the Leash referee, he's made a decision here that could have a huge impact on this game, a huge bearing on this game. We have 3 minutes and 50 seconds left. We have a penalty. Score is Cork, 17 points. Mayo, three goals and 10 points. This is a pivotal moment in this game. Judged to be a foul, judged to be a penalty.
She's a very good penalty to take her. She's going to go through.
Emer Scally that's going to take this. She takes it. What a save for Yvonne Byrne. Fantastic stuff here. Fantastic stuff for Yvonne Byrne. She watched the ball all the way and just tipped it around the post. Fantastic.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, unbelievable save.
And a chance to put it out around the middle. That's down to Sarah Rowe, and it's Aileen Gilroy. Aileen Gilroy wins that ball, brings it across the halfway line. She is steaming ahead here. Can she flash an opportunity? Cora is there beside her. Can she get the ball off to Cora? Can Cora get a score here to put them into the final? Cora with the shot.
Yes!
What a score for Cora there. Fantastic. Aileen Gilroy Wick, who punched through the Cork defence, drove right through the centre. With 1 minute and 15 seconds here, it's a 2 point game. Mayo 2 points up. We have a player down on the ground. Player that's down on the ground, Niamh Kelly. Niamh Kelly was down on the ground there, carrying a knock. She doesn't look like she has a knock right now. They could sense it's an All-Ireland final here. The All-Ireland final is Dave against Mayo. They're counting down the clock here. And that's it. A fantastic performance from Mayo. Fantastic. A two-point win. 18 points to Cork. 3 goals and 11 points. This is a fantastic win for Mayo. Unfancied coming down here. Cork were the favourites, the bookies' favourites. This is a fantastic win, and what it means to the supporters here, what it means to the players, and this fantastic Cork team, as we said, who are going for 7 in a row, they're out on their feet, Michelle.
Out on their feet, and as you can hear from the crowd, probably hear it on the radio, absolutely fantastic support from the Mayo ladies here today. Support definitely helped the Mayo ladies over the line. In the last 10 minutes, the support has dug deep, the team dug deep. Unbelievable performance from the whole team. There wasn't one player you could signal out on the Hope Mayo team. Every one of them dug deep, and you could see there it was a complete fantastic team effort.
We have the fans coming onto the pitch. We have the Cork players going around with the Mayo players shaking their hands. Great sportsmanship here. It wasn't a dirty game. It was a very, very good game.
Very open game, in fairness. One of the best games I've seen in many years in ladies football. I mean, completely open. There was really no dirt. There was no malicious intention, any tactics around that. Two teams just going hell for leather to get into a final. You can see how much it meant to both teams. I do feel sorry for the Cork team, lots of the girls, you know, they were going for, they came back like reach stack and all that kind of stuff, and young players coming through. But that team are a young and building team, the Cork team. They left everything on the pitch, they went for the game. But the Mayo team for me today, best performance I've seen ever, I think, actually, for the Mayo ladies.
But when you look